Hi again, everyone. In this video, I want to give you just a few more tips about how to edit and reuse commands on your calculator. And I also want to show you how to use the fraction functions on your calculator. So let's take a look at an expression like this one, 13 squared minus 4 times 2 times 20. So let's say that you've entered that command on your calculator, and then after you press equal, you notice that instead of 13 squared, you accidentally put in 14 squared. Well, what you can do is scroll up to access previous commands. So the command we have here is just the last one, so I'll only need to press the up arrow one time, and that lets me start editing that command. So I can right arrow, put my cursor over the number that I want to change, and then change that 4 to a 3, and press enter again, and then we have the result we needed. Or let's say you've made a different mistake. In this case, instead of 13 squared, I have 3 squared, so I have a number missing. So again, I can just use the up arrow key to edit that command, but notice that if I put the 1 in there, it's written over the 3, so I'm going to have to re-enter everything anyway, unless I change the cursor to insert mode. So to do that, notice that the second function of the delete key is INS, so that stands for insert. So if I say second delete, that puts me in insert mode, and now I can enter the 3 without writing over the next character. And notice how the cursor has changed. In insert mode, it just blinks, but if we change back to strike over mode, you can see that solid rectangle that's blinking. So in this mode, it's going to type over whatever your cursor is over, but in insert mode, it's going to let you insert extra characters. Of course, I mentioned the delete key, so if you have an extra character, like here I have 21 where I only meant to have 2, you can just use the arrow key to go back to the character that you want to get rid of, and when your cursor is blinking over that character, just press delete and it's gone. I will just point out to you too that over here on the right side of the screen, you see this little arrow pointing up. That means there are more past commands that I can access if I continue to press the up arrow button. Now just keep in mind that if any of your commands use the ANS function, it's going to call on the last result that the calculator found. So it's not going to maybe use the one that you had in mind when you made this command, it's going to use the last one, so just be aware of that. Now let's talk about how to enter fractions on this calculator. So notice that you have a button labeled A, B over C, and it looks like a mixed number, but it's made out of letters. So that is the fraction button. And we can do operations like this using this fraction key. So I'm going to enter 3 fraction 5 plus 7 fraction 8 equals. Now notice that the calculator has given me the result in a mixed number form. So what you're seeing here is 1 and 19 fortieths. Now a lot of times we need our results in an improper fraction form. So notice that the second function of the fraction button looks like a mixed number being converted to an improper fraction and back again. You see the double arrow means we can convert either way. So if I say second fraction button equals, it has now converted that mixed number to an improper fraction form. You can also have the calculator simplify a fraction for you by simply entering the fraction and pressing equal. So I'll enter here 125 fraction 240 equals, and it simplifies it for me to 25 over 48. Now I just want you to be aware that anytime you do fraction operations with the calculator, if the result is greater than 1, it's going to display the results in mixed number form, and you'll have to convert to improper form if you need the answer in that form. So let's say we want to simplify this fraction, so I'm going to enter 340 fraction 153, and notice that the result comes out in mixed number form, and then I can convert to improper form by using the second function of that button, and I see that it's 20 over 9. And finally, I just want to show you the F to D button. This button will let you convert from fraction form to decimal form, or the other way around, from decimal to fraction. You need to understand that the fraction button and the divide key really are doing the same thing. A fraction bar is a division symbol, but the reason we have both on our calculator is that if you use the divide key, the calculator assumes that you want everything done in decimal form. And if you use the fraction key, the calculator assumes that you want everything done in fraction form. Keep in mind that at any time you can switch from one form to the other. So let's add 2/3 plus 4/5, but instead of using the fraction key, I'm going to use the divide key. 2 divided by 3 plus 4 divided by 5 equals, and of course it gives me the answer in decimal form, but I can convert that to fraction form by using the f to d function. So second f to d equals, there is the answer in mixed number form, and then I can convert that to improper fraction form using the second function on the fraction key. And so we see that the final result here is 22 over 15. On the other hand, if you have the improper fraction and you wish you were back in decimal form, you can convert back to decimal form the same way. So second f to d equals, and now we're back in decimal form.